Well, shalom, friends, and welcome to House of David. Today we're gonna
shalom.
Continue, amen. We're gonna continue today our celebration, and as we explain it about Hanukkah and other things that God has put into our heart, as we approaching the end of the year, and actually this is the time of celebration of Hanukkah. And yesterday we began to talk about what Hanukkah is all about, and I believe a lot of people, they know what Hanukkah is, but do they really celebrate in their heart? Do they really celebrate as any other holiday? They celebrate maybe not without the gifts, but at least in the spirit, in the heart, by celebrating, by believing God for miracle, by believing God for rededication, by believing God that God is going to do something in their life. And maybe while we're teaching about Hanukkah, which is the feast of dedication, maybe we should rededicate our thoughts, our ways of things in our life. Maybe we should think to rededicate our ways as we walk in with God, and even our faith.
Spiritual light. Yes.
Even our faith. Yes. Amen. Mm-hmm. So, first of all, thank you so much for joining me today. And it's great. It's great to have you on the scene. We both talking about the same thing. And
we're excited to be here.
And it's wonderful. It's wonderful. So, praise be to God. Yesterday, we begin to talk about Hanukkah and explain people what Hanukkah is all about. Basically, it's the Feast of Dedication. And I mentioned about the scripture in John chapter 10, verse 22, that Jesus did not miss the opportunity when he was walking in the land. He came not only to celebrate, but to bring the message through that feast. And it says in John 10, 22, he says, "Now it was the Feast of Dedication," which is Hanukkah in Hebrew, "in Jerusalem, and it was winter," so you know, and as you mentioned yesterday, that
usually it's happened between November and December.
It's, yeah, and you said that it was December. The 25th of Kislev, yes. Which is December.
Yes.
It's interesting, 25th.
That was
How did you come
that
up
was,
with this number?
No, I didn't come out. That's the history.
Yeah, I understand, but where did you get that?
I researched it. That was in a history.
So you talk
about Hanukkah.
When the
25th
actual
of Kislev, the actual dedication of the temple, Gennady, occurred on 25th of Kislev, which is in December.
Isn't it interesting? Well, so it says that Jesus came into Jerusalem in that Feast of Dedication, and let's say that was the date. And he walked into the temple in Solomon's porch, and then he began to present the message. He began to present the message. And I have some powerful, interesting revelation in that, but as we begin to touch about the subject yesterday, let's continue where we stopped. Maybe you could continue.
Well, we stopped about the Jewish people. They were standing for their faith. They were oppressed by Greek emperors and rulers to give up their Jewish faith, to give up their Jewish beliefs, to stop keeping kosher laws, to stop worshiping in a temple, to celebrate the Shabbat, to have a circumcision, and all the rich traditions which was given to them by God. And they were threatened by death. And amazing thing, many of them died with the one word on their lips, Adonai, Elohim, Ehad, God is one. And they were dying, they were giving their life for their faith in God. Isn't that amazing? But the Lord always have, there was a lot of them who actually did, wanted to escape the persecution, mm-hmm. and want to have the easy life. And it's always like that. It's always going to be the people who would want to escape the persecution and have it easy.
But well, it's a natural inclination
on our human nature,
yeah.
to do what is easy. But there is a choice, Gennady, exactly. Yes. But there is always a remnant. And that was the remnant in the village of Modin. It was the priest, his name was Matiyahu. And when Syrian officer came and built the altar, the pagan altar of the pagan gods, he came and he said, you bow to them. Matiyahu basically slain this officer. And he said, no, we're going to worship the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And he took his sons and they ran to the hills of Judea. Mm-hmm. And that's how everything started. That's how the rebellion, I would say, to this Greek conquerors started. They gathered the band of a few maybe fighters, faithful one. They all came to Judean hills, and they were attacking from time to time all these pagan altars where they built it, and they were destroying them, mm-hmm. and they were liberating mm-hmm. the places, the villages where Jewish people.
And it is interesting that it took a couple of years to do.
Yes.
I mean, they were doing the will of God, absolutely, but yet God didn't give them the victory overnight.
No.
They were fighting
they
for
had to
each
fight.
Step of the way.
They
so
had to fight.
Ourselves, we need to fight each step of the way. Let me just, if I could interfere for a moment.
Yeah.
Our ministry right now is in a lot of difficulties. We're going through a lot of problems right now, not spiritual, but we're going through financial difficulties. Financial difficulties. We finish in the year and we are in big debt to our television stations. Unfortunately, and we have to fight each step
it's
of the way.
Test.
I wish God will come and bring these things through and give us a victory right away. But the thing is this, that actually I could relate this to myself, that we are trying to break everything that the devil is put at a stepping stone for us. And every stepping stone we try to destroy by one day at a time, it's not easy for us. You know, when you own to the stations like $65,000 back, it's not easy.
We're actually on the brink of stopping the programs, Gennady.
And
I don't think this is God's will.
We don't want to do that.
I don't believe this is God's will to stop this program. I don't believe God's will for us as a Jewish Messianic believer to stop blessing the body of the Messiah. I don't believe that,
no,
Gennady.
No, that's not God's calling.
I believe that's our mission. I believe that's our calling to bless the body of the Messiah,
of course,
the body of Jesus. And we are blessings.
But because of this difficulties, financial difficulties that we have at the end of this year. Like yesterday, we were already talking to many of you who are watching. Maybe you would become a partner today, because we do need partnership. Every ministry is working on partnership. Every church is built on people.
Yes.
As the Bible says that you are those stones. That God is precious stones that God is building, right?
Yes.
So each precious stone that is God is building is a member of this church, of this ministry. And you understand that everything works just like that on partnership. And without partners, we are actually, I may say, I don't want to say it. I don't want to really, you know, say that that's what it is, but it is possible that we'll have to whether stop our television program or cut down to almost nothing. And we don't want to do that. We don't want to do that is because this is God's calling in our life, and God is ministering to many people. Svetlana, so many people got blessed. We have so many phone calls, testimonies. We have the fruit. People getting saved. Jewish people were writing to us from jails that they were watching our program in the jail. We had letters. And they accepted Yeshua as their Savior. That is the fruit. So, I mean, God has given us this marvelous opportunity. God has given us all that we have right now. We have all the tools to work with.
Amen.
To bring media forth. And not only with television, but with our website and all kind of things that God has given us. That we may continue bringing the gospel. We are Jewish Messianic Ministry, as I mentioned that yesterday, that we are the only Jewish Messianic television ministry that is Canadian. Now, can Christians, believers, support this Jewish Messianic, that is the only Jewish Messianic ministry that is Canadian-based?
Mm. Amen.
Can you support this? Can you stand with us and help us to rise up that we will never have again this kind of tale that is behind us right now? So right now we are on the verge of decisions, what we're going to do. We don't want to stop our television program. We don't want to stop our webcasting and our ministry period because we didn't meet the budget. No, we want to meet the budget. And I know that with partnership that will be increased, I believe, we can meet that budget and everything will be normal again. So we are also fighting that, you know, stepping stones that the devil really put before us as this a priest and his family.
His sons, Maccabeans.
Yes.
Maccabees.
And do you know what? The powerful story of that is that at the end, they won the battle.
Amen.
They won the battle.
They were persistent.
They were persistent.
But Gennady, they were together. Even, you know, that's interesting point to stress, that they were few. They were a few, and they were fighting against 40,000 of Syrian army who was very well-armed, well-equipped. Mm-hmm. They had lots of money and power behind them. And this band, maybe 300 people, maybe 500 the most. Can you imagine?
Svetlana,
against 40,000.
They were fighting Alexander the Great's army. They were the conquerors of the world.
Exactly.
They came all the way, never mind Israel, they came all the way to India. They conquered half of Europe.
Right.
They took so much. And yet, that little group
of
Jewish believers, because of God's help.
Amen.
And I believe
they were determined, Gennady.
I believe we could do the same with House of Dead Ministries. Yes, we are small, but yet we are powerful in God.
Amen.
We are powerful in God. And it doesn't matter what we're fighting against. It doesn't matter how big the giant is. I just want to encourage you people. Get on board today with
Amen.
Us.
We believe and for help 500 us, partners, Gennady.
At least 500 partners.
500 faithful partners.
Faithful partners, Amen. Yes, a year. So that we may continue this very important ministry. So give us a call. Become a partner. Or give online today. Do something. And help us to achieve this goal. Let's move on.
Well, what's happened? This small band of people, they were fighting, and they finally took over Jerusalem and the temple. But you know, the temple was destroyed and robbed. You know that the gold. It's interesting to say, Gennady, the detail that mm-hmm. the golden menorah and all the articles of the temple, the holy articles which was dedicated mm-hmm. by Moses and anointed, right, for the service of the temple, they were stolen. Do you know that there was even the menorah was stolen? So they had to make the menorah. They had to make the menorah out of less precious, maybe not golden, but some maybe bronze, mm-hmm. maybe some other mm-hmm. Material, and they had to find the oil, because according to the law of Moses, the oil need to be prepared, and the oil need to be holy, anointed oil. I want to just read a little bit,
sure.
right,
yes.
about the what is the components of the oil. Okay, it's from Exodus 30, starting from verse 23. And also take for yourself quality spices. It was spices, 500 shekels of liquid myrrh, half as much sweet-smelling cinnamon, 250 shekels, 250 shekels of sweet-smelling cane, 500 shekels of cassia, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, and a hin of olive oil. And you shall make from this a holy anointing oil, an ointment compounded according to the art of the perfumer. It shall be a holy anointing oil. With it you shall anoint the tabernacle of the meeting and the ark of the testimony, the table and all the utensils, the lampstand and everything on it. So this oil was very, very costly, and they were very sacred oil. It was a precious oil, Gennady. And when they came to the temple, guess what? It was just a little, a jar left, which was only one jar, but
yeah.
that was not enough to burn continually. The menorah supposed to burn continually. The Holy Spirit of God supposed to have a fire and burn in our
Amen.
Heart continually. Since the new birth till the end, we should have the fire, the holy fire of God continually. And that, but that was not enough. So they faithfully lit up the menorah, Gennady, mm-hmm. and miraculously, they trust God, they pray, probably for a miracle, and miraculously, this light was, the light was enough, was enough lighting for 8 days.
8 days.
Until they prepared the new supply of oil.
So it takes about 8 days to
prepare. It take about 7-8 days to prepare.
Yes.
Exactly. So this time, and during this time of preparation, the oil, the menorah was burning on itself. And that's why, because of that element of this miraculous element, the Jewish people begin to celebrate, and they begin to have the celebration of Hanukkah. Mm-hmm. That's why the joy and the celebration began, and that's happened from generation to generation.
You know, the Bible says in Psalms, after the heavy night of troubles or temptations or sorrows, the morning of joy is coming.
Amen.
Every celebration never been celebrated without a victory, and victory never been taken but through fight.
Amen.
So Hanukkah is not only about celebration, it's about victory and a fight.
Yes,
about it's about fight. Faithfulness.
Yes.
And like I said, our ministry right now is fighting for its
Amen.
Life.
Amen.
It's like that baby in a womb. We're fighting for our life here. It's
well, we're fighting not for our, we're fighting for the cause of God.
For the cause
we
of God, but
we're fighting
that
for
we want
for
to
what
sustain this ministry.
Amen.
The life of the ministry has to be sustained, and we do need help. We do need help, and I believe, like, it's not only myself and you and a small staff that we have here, but people that are watching us, we could pull together. We could pull
Amen.
Together. And we really want to begin the new year, with a new mandate in our life, which is financial. I believe that God will have to set us free with financial obligations like that. So we would like to begin a new year with much better based financially than ever before. And that comes through partnership. I believe the $65,000 debt that we own in right now to the stations could be wiped out in one day.
Well, we need only 65 people with a $1,000 gift.
That's all.
Or maybe 130 people with a $500 bill gift.
Well, that's it.
This is not
Across
much.
Across Canada.
Across Canada. This is nothing. This is nothing. You know, Gennady, God could have just dropped this money from heaven. Many times I said, Lord, you have all the riches. You have all the treasures. And you can just drop a little or a big stone, precious stone, or a piece of gold, and we could be fine. We could have been probably free. But you know, God does not do that many times. God used people. God used his people. And he steered their hearts.
Yes.
He likes to stir up their hearts. And he wants to see how much faith they will have. I understand we are in a time of holidays. And everybody would like to have gifts and buy gifts. And every single... But you know, I think that the most important gift to Yeshua, to our Jesus, is to stand with Jewish
his
people.
Help is to
is
help,
help
his
the ministries. Help the ministries who are bringing the light to the nations. The light of God. As Yeshua said, he was walking in a temple, and mm-hmm. he said, I am the light of the world. Those who believe in me will never walk in the darkness, but have the light. And we are trying to bring the light to some darker corners of this earth, to different nations who probably never heard about this, who never know the light, who walk in the darkness, and we're trying to be one of the many voices. So we really need your faithful support. We need your stand with us. We need your faithfulness.
Yes.
And dedication. Maybe right now you are seeking the Lord for certain things, but God wants you to dedicate, to rededicate your temple, your spiritual walk with him. Maybe God is speaking to you, it's time to rededicate yourself. It's time to be serious. You know, Gennady, when I look at the news, we're living in a very difficult time. Probably the most important times of the history.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is in confusion. The nation of Israel is in danger. And they have less and less friends, and they have more and more enemies.
Mm.
And you know what? If you stand with Israel, if you stand with Jewish people, you're going to be blessed. You're going to be blessed not only in this life, but you're going to be blessed also in the life after. God giving rewards. God rewards his people. God rewards his faithful people. And I really believe that we need to stand for Israel right now. We need to stand and make a voice, not just to be passive. Yeah, we love Jewish people. We love singing songs. That's wonderful. But we need to do something active. We need to do something tangible, Gennady.
Yes.
You know, we do need to get involved. And I really implore you, me and Gennady, we do really ask you to really pray about that, what God wants you to do, what amount God wants you to send as a love offering. It really encourages, it really will help us. And we really want you to pray for us. We want to be an heir.
For one and only one reason is because God has called us. This ministry is benefiting you. It's not benefiting us. It's benefiting you and everyone who is watching. Some people may don't like it, maybe some people, whatever, but those whom God is really bringing attention to, they are benefiting. So it's not about us, it's about you. It's about what God wants to do in your life through this ministry. And, well, we need to stay on our feet. We need to stay on. We are looking for at least 500 partners this year. You can become a partner even before the new year. You can call us right away as you see our phone number on your screen and say, I'd like to become a partner of this amount of money a month. I'd like to do this, I'd like to do that. So, but it's up to you what you want to do, but it's the thing is how you want to do that. How, why? And it's the condition of our heart. So, as I said yesterday, dedication of the temple was a wonderful thing as an example. So maybe we could dedicate our partnership. You can dedicate your partnership with the House of the Ministries for a year or more. You know, we have some partners that have been supporting us for 13, 14 years.
Yes, it's amazing.
They support, but they're precious people that really
faithful
understand what we're doing, and they're still supporting us. We do have partners, but not as many. Not as many that we need, not what we'd like to, but what we need to sustain this ministry. Like, again, I believe God, and I know that God wants us to stand on our feet, but if the finances are not going to be here, we will have to close the program because we cannot continue. We cannot continue and accumulate this kind
and
of...
And it's break my heart, Gennady, that we will have to do that.
Last thing I want to do. And I don't believe we will have to if our precious viewers, like you watching today, will stand up and say no. Not just proclaiming and believing God and say, Gennady, I'm praying for you. No, I appreciate your prayers. It's a wonderful thing that you pray for me. But we need to act. If Maccabees will only pray
and say,
yeah, we are standing with the truth and God, we're praying, we're seeking you, we're just putting our head into ashes and we pray, and not to act and put even their life in jeopardy because of their faith and belief for the temple of God. I don't think God would give them that victory. God works through the hands of people. God works through lives of people. God works through our real people. Not only their prayers, but their substance.
You know, Gennady, Amen. The thought came to me. I'm going to be very quick. We are almost finishing here. In a time when they found only one jar of oil, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they by faith, they have a little oil, right?
Yes.
Maybe you have something, a very small amount. Maybe you have just a little seed and you think that's not even going to be matter if I'm going to send. But yes, it is matter. Even a small amount. If you're going to be dedicated for us for a year, it's going to be important. You know, everything is important. And if you allow the small jar of oil, I would say symbolically, to put it in the hands of God, God will multiply it. God will multiply it in your household, and God multiply it here. It's going to be for the benefit of the gospel. So this little jar of oil, what was left, they put it faithfully, and it was lighting the candelabra for 8 days.
Yeah.
So that was a miracle. God created a miracle.
What you want to say that?
It to the hands of God what you have.
What you want to say is God can do things for you and I,
Amen.
As He has done for them, but they did an action.
They had to do it.
Acted. Upon what God said. Well, we come into the end of this program today. And thank you so much for watching. And let's celebrate Hanukkah together with nothing but victory. Let us come up this week.
Let's pray.
With nothing but victory. Father, in the name of Yeshua, I just uplift everyone who is watching today. And I want to praise you and thank you for everything you have done, not only through this year, but through this 14 years of us being on the air. And I pray that we will continue, and I pray that we will gain partners, this Jewish Messianic ministry, the only Jewish Messianic television ministry in Canadian, will gain enough partners to be a successful, powerful ministry that will bring many to Jesus, Jews and Gentiles alike. And we give you praise for that in Yeshua's name. Well, thank you so much for standing with us today, and watch us tomorrow as we're going to continue on Hanukkah. Tomorrow, the last episode for this week that we're going to have. God bless you. Shalom to you.
God bless you. Shalom.
We love you. God loves you. And we will see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
House of David, Jewish Messianic Ministry, is produced and sponsored by viewers like you. We appreciate your support, which is allowing us to continue to broadcast our programming. Thank you, and God bless you. Shalom.